Hi, my name's Cody. I'm a product owner at Ema, and I worked with our developers on our brand new Salesforce integration, Ema for Salesforce. We've been working on this for a long time. We think it's going to open up a lot of really cool opportunities for Salesforce users, and I'd like to take just a couple minutes and show you around. Ema for Salesforce is available to download from the Salesforce App Exchange, and once you download and install it, it's going to appear in your Salesforce account right alongside the other applications in your application menu. When you navigate to the Ema Email Marketing application, you'll see that you have some new sections there, including Ema Groups, Ema Mailings, and Ema Setup. But before we take a look at anything that's going on there, I want to take a look at a standard Salesforce lead record and show you some of the things that are going on there. At the core of the Ema for Salesforce application is a two-way data sync between Ema and Salesforce. So if I make a change in Scott's record here, that change will be immediately reflected in his Ema profile as well. Now, if I scroll down a bit, I'll see that Ema for Salesforce has added some new elements to this profile as well. For example, if I take a look at Scott's record here, I can see what Ema groups he's a member of, and I can also see his response activity for recent Ema mailings. And if I want to, I can actually add Scott to a new Ema group right from his lead profile. Now, these related lists for Ema groups and Ema response activities are optional, so I don't have to add them to my Salesforce profiles. The good news is that even if I decide not to add these new lists to my leader contact profiles, all of their email response activity will still appear in their standard activity list in Salesforce. Speaking of response activity, I'm going to head over to the Ema mailings section and show you how Ema for Salesforce handles response activity for individual Ema mailings. Here on the Ema mailings main page, I can see all of my most recently viewed Ema mailings. And if I want to see the entire history of my Ema mailing activity, I'll just click View All and see all of the Ema email campaigns that I've sent since I activated Ema for Salesforce. So I want to get a closer look at the detailed response for an individual email campaign, so I'm going to take a look at the Burnside Bridge Spring Newsletter mailing. And at a glance, you can probably tell that the detailed response activity you're seeing here is the same activity that you'll see in your Ema email account. So the response overview will tell you the numbers of people who opened, clicked, and shared your mailing. You can drill down to your social media results to see which of those shares were on Facebook, Twitter, or LinkedIn. And you can also take a look down here and see the response activity by individual respondent. And if you want to see this mailing as it appeared to your audience in their inbox, you can click See This Mailing and it'll open up a preview for you. There's one more section that we should take a look at, and that's the Ema Groups section. Here, you'll be able to see all of the Ema audience groups that you've chosen to sync with your Salesforce account. One thing that I want to point out here, you don't have to sync every group in your Ema account with your Salesforce account. And this is handy because if you have a lot of old audience groups from events that you held back in 2009 or promotional campaigns that have already come and gone, you probably don't need to sync those groups to Salesforce. I'm going to take a look at the monthly newsletter group, and you'll see that when I click in, I can see the entire roster of this Ema audience group right in Salesforce. Now, if there's somebody that I want to add to this group, I can do so by clicking this button. And I'm going to add the lead record for Jason Bynum into this monthly newsletter group. I can also create new Ema groups right from my Salesforce account by clicking the New Ema Group button. If I want to start fresh with a brand new Ema audience group, all I have to do is give it a name. But one of the really cool things about Ema for Salesforce is that you can actually create audience groups using the custom reports that you're already running. If I take a look at the Leads May audience group, you'll see that I actually built this audience group by importing a Salesforce report that captured all of the leads that were created in May. And I don't have to stop there. In fact, if I head over to the Reports section, we'll see that Ema for Salesforce actually brings in some custom reports of its own. And you can use installed reports like these as springboards for your own custom reporting. For example, in this custom report, Spring Email Opens Communication, I wanted to find all of my leads in the communication industry who opened my Spring Email campaign. And now that I have this Salesforce report, I can use it to build an Ema audience group in just a few clicks. I'll just find the report in my Ema Emails folder and send it directly to my Ema audience groups. And here they are. Now I can send these folks an email in my Ema account whenever I want. Now, Ema for Salesforce is a free application, and after you've installed it, it'll take most users about a half an hour to 45 minutes to configure. But once you've installed it and configured it, it'll be there and ready to go for as long as you want to keep it in your account. I hope you've enjoyed this tour, and if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to get in touch.